Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for September the 4th of 2019, well, it is titled The Spider Nebula in Infrared. So what do we see here? Well, we see an example of two emission nebulae here. And the one on the left, the larger one stretching across a good stretch of the image, would be the Spider Nebula. The smaller one towards the right hand side would be the fly. So the impression here is that the spider is chasing the fly. And of course, in this case, the spider will never be able to catch up to the fly because they are nebulae out there in space. Now, when I talk about emission nebulae, and I've mentioned them before, we've looked at them in a lot of these other images over the years. And what we've always talked about is the red color of an emission nebula, how an emission nebula is red because of the excitation of hydrogen gas. Now, this one looks green. Well, that really doesn't have anything to do with changes in composition or anything different about it. And in fact, were this image taken in the visible part of the spectrum, then it would still look red. What we're looking at here is an infrared image. So this is taken by the Spitzer Space Telescope, which is in orbit around the Earth and is now finishing 16 years of observing the sky in the infrared. Now, of course, our eyes aren't sensitive to the infrared, so an infrared image to our eyes would be invisible. So it is, of course, adjusted with false color. And in this case, the greens and different levels of intensities of the greens are used to represent the specific wavelengths that are being observed here. So it's not that this would look green under any sense. It would not be the image that we see here would be detecting the infrared radiation that our eyes are not sensitive to. A visible light image would look very red by comparison. And in fact, if you follow one of the links in the description down below, you will see where it says NGC 1931, the fly. And if you click on that link, it'll actually take you to a previous picture of the day. And you can see there, taken in the visible part of the spectrum, we do see it's very distinctly a red color. So we can see that image again if you click on that one link, and as I'm showing you right here. So we're looking at, again, at our image for today. We do see the nebulae, the spider to the left and the smaller fly to the right. And of course, we see a number of other stars around this area too. Stars primarily put out visible light, but do put off infrared as well. And in fact, the cooler stars are much brighter in the infrared than they are in the visible portion of the spectrum. And here, of course, we do get to see it in an image taken by the Spitzer Space Telescope. So that was our picture of the day for September the 4th of 2019. It was titled The Spider Nebula in Infrared. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.